third baseman, number 42, A.J. Reed. Batting fourth, the right fielder, number 20, Camden Early. Batting fifth, the designated hitter, number 23, William McKenzie. Batting sixth, the first baseman, number 2, Nick Logan. Batting seventh, the shortstop, number 10, Benjamin Hankey. Batting eighth, the catcher, number 14, Evan Nykum. Batting ninth, the second baseman, number 6, Michael Galanos. Starting on the mound tonight for the Little Giants, number 17, Nicholas Wengler. Let's meet the starting lineup for your Rose-Hulman Fightin' Engineers. Leading off the Engineers, the designated hitter, number 30, Cade Klein. Batting second, the shortstop, number 7, Peter Rogers. Batting third, the second baseman, number 10, Coulter Cuyard Rodak. Batting fourth, the first baseman, number 24, Dalton Busboo. Batting fifth, the third baseman, number 35, Connor O'Connell. Batting sixth, the left fielder, number 34, Tyler Otrusco. Batting seventh, the catcher, number 41, Mason Rasmussen. Batting eighth, the right fielder, number 19, Mark Serdinak. Batting ninth, the center fielder, number 5, Garrett Lloyd. And starting on the mound tonight for the Fighting Engineers, number 21, Zacchaeus Carr. Fans, at this time, we ask you to please rise and remove your caps as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem, performed tonight by Rose-Hulman Jr., Isabel Hout.
Hey. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to RHIT.TV. You're watching Rose-Hulman Baseball here as the Rose-Hulman Fighting Engineers host the Wabash College Little Giants in today's non-conference matchup. To meet the starting lineup for the visitors, the Wabash College Little Giants, leading off the center fielder, Reese Bauer, batting second, the left fielder, Camden Sheet. The third baseman batting third, A.J. Reed, batting fourth, the right fielder, number 20, Camden Early. The designated hitter batting fifth is William McKenzie. The first baseman batting sixth, Nick Logan. Batting seventh, the shortstop, Benjamin Hanke. The catcher batting eighth is Evan Nykum. And batting ninth, the second baseman, Michael Galanos. On the mound for Rose-Hulman to start this one is the right-hander, Zacchaeus Carr. Carr making his first start of the season, and just the fourth start of his career here as a fighting engineer. And the first pitch in there for strike one from Carr. As I mentioned, Carr, a junior from Mahomet, Illinois, went to Mahomet Seymour High School. And squares to bunt is Bauer, but that went in there, and it's no balls, two strikes to the righty. The 0-2 pitch. Struck him out swinging. Three straight fastballs. And the first out of the inning recorded by Carr.
Next up to bat, the left fielder, number 18.
Carr on the season, making his sixth appearance, leads the team in wins with a 2-0 record out of the bullpen, has a 5.40 ERA. And four straight strikes as that one in there. To the two-hole hitter, Camden Scheit. And he's going to line this one back up the middle, and a one-out single for the Little Giants.
Now batting the third baseman, number 42.
Scheit picking up his 23rd hit of the season. And that'll bring up the third baseman, A.J. Reed, comes in hitting .327 on the season, eight extra base hits. Last week in the win over Greenville, Reed came up just short of the cycle. Finished with a single, a triple, and a home run, and in his last at bat, he ripped a ball down the left field line that would have been a for sure double, but it went foul by about 6 feet and just missed the cycle. The 1-0 pitch, runner goes, pitch outside, Rasmussen throws down, not in time. And Scheit in there with his third stolen base of the season. Little Giants on the year, now 16 for 22 stealing. It's a 73% success rate. And that one is going to hit off of A.J. Reed. That two-seamer just tailed in and caught him on the arm. And it's two on, one out here for the Little Giants.
Stepping up to the plate, the right fielder, number 20, Camden Early.
That'll bring up Camden Early. Early has started every game this season for Wabash. Comes in with 18 hits. Only two for extra bases, has a pair of doubles. So just a .339 slugging percentage. He looks, and he's going to square to bunt here. Bunts that one foul. It's 0-1. Early a senior from Pendleton, Indiana. Went to Pendleton Heights High School. And he fouls this one straight back. It's no balls, two strikes. The 0-2 pitch from Carr, looks to second. And the pitch. In the dirt, blocked by Rasmussen. A great block as he holds the runners at first and second. Scheit looked to get a jump to third, but he thought better. And the count goes to one ball, two strikes. Carr looking for a ground ball double play to get out of this inning. The pitch popped up out of play. Wabash does not hit it into a lot of double plays, just 8 through 15 games. And the complete opposite end of the spectrum for Rose-Hulman as they rank top 5 in the country in double plays turned this season with 22 through their 16 games. So we'll see which one wins out here. Count stays 1-2. Shite on second early, or Reed leading off first early at the dish. This one misses up and away. 2-2. Curveball in there for strike 3. Caught the inside corner. Second strikeout of the inning for Carr. And there's 2 down. Carr came into the year just 4 strikeouts in 6 2/3 innings, but he's mowed down 2 batters here in the first. And that'll bring up the designated hitter, William McKenzie, to the dish. That one catches the outside corner. It's 0-1. McKenzie, a sophomore from Brownsburg, Indiana. And that one misses away, 1-1. This Wabash team made up of almost entirely players from the state of Indiana. Just one player, a bullpen pitcher, Ashton Moore from Colorado, the rest of the team from here in state. 1-1 curveball in there, it's 1-2. The count runs to 1-2. Carr looking to get out of the jam. The 1-2 fouled off down the right field line. It's a big runner on second base for Rose-Hulman on the year. 8-0 when scoring the first run of the game. Just 3-6 when their opponents score first. So putting up a 0 here in the top of the first inning is big for the Rose-Hulman team. That one misses up. 2-2. Two in the dirt, and the count runs full. A base hit for sure will score Scheit from second now as the runners will be off on the pitch. Big opportunity for McKenzie to put the Little Giants on the board first. The payoff pitch. Just misses low, and the bases will be loaded here with 2 outs in the top of the first inning for the first baseman, Nick Logan. Logan making just his 9th start of the year, hitting .324, 5 extra base hits, including a team-high 3 triples. That one hits the outside corner. It's 0-1. Carr doing a good job getting ahead on hitters. First pitch strike to 5 of the 6 batters he's faced now. That one misses 1-1. Just misses inside. Count runs to 2-1. It's a bullpen day for the Fighting Engineers as they're coming off 4 games last weekend. Split with Mount St. Joseph on Saturday and swept Franklin on Sunday. And the count goes to 3-1. Despite it being a bullpen day, you cannot afford a big inning from your starter here. That fouled off. And the count runs full. Runners will be off on the pitch. Base hit will score two. McKenzie second on the team in RBIs this year. Of course, Nick Logan with 11 RBIs on the season. Looking to pick up a couple more. The payoff pitch. Swung on and missed, strike three. Carr gets out of the jam. And after one inning a play, it's 0-0 here at Artneff Field. Welcome back to RHIT.TV. Rose-Hulman puts up a zero in the bottom of the first inning, despite the Little Giants loading the bases. Now to make the starting lineup for the Fighting Engineers, leading off the designated hitter, Cade Klein. Batting second, the shortstop, Peter Rogers. The second baseman batting third is Coulter Couillard-Rodak. Dalton Busboom in the cleanup spot at first base. Batting fifth, the third baseman, Connor O'Connell. The left fielder batting sixth is Tyler Otrusco. Batting seventh, the catcher, Mason Rasmussen. The right fielder batting eighth is Mark Sardinak. And batting ninth, the center fielder is Garrett Lloyd. And on the mound for the Little Giants is Nicholas Weingler, the freshman from Evansville Wrights High School. And he delivers that one in there to Cade Klein for the first pitch strike. Wangler comes into the game 0-1 with his record, with an 8.22 ERA and 9 strikeouts. Making his third start of the season, he's pitched 7.2 innings in his 2 starts and 1 relief appearance on the season. He's ahead quickly, 0-2 here to Klein. This one misses up and away. It's 1-1, 1-2. The 1-2 pitch misses away. It's 2 balls, 2 strikes. Klein has been the top hitter on this Rose-Hulman ball club on the season, hitting .429 on the year, 30 hits, 9 for extra bases, as he leads the team in home runs and triples with 4 home runs and 3 3-baggers. But he chases that high heater, and the first out of the inning is the strikeout. Let's take a look at the Little Giants across the diamond. The left fielder, Camden Scheitz, in center, Bauer, and in right is Early. Reed at the hot corner with Hinkey and Galanos up the middle. Nick Logan at first. And your battery today, Evan Newcomb and Nicholas Wangler. Rodgers fouls off that first pitch, and it's 0-1. Rodgers second on the team in home runs this year with a pair. Hit both of them in back-to-back innings in the last game of our spring trip against Houghton. A 12-5 victory for the Fighting Engineers. He had a three-run shot in the third inning and followed it up with a solo shot in the fourth inning. That one hits the outside corner. It's one ball, two strikes. Misses in, it count goes to 2-2. Rodgers in his career 3-for-10 against the Little Giants, has two runs scored and an RBI in the last four meetings. And he's going to ground this one to third, the backhand by Reed, throw across the diamond, and there's two away. That'll bring up Coulter Couillard-Rodak to the dish. Moving down from the two-hole to the three-hole for today's game, with Rodgers moving up in the lineup. Couillard-Rodak, a senior from Lafayette, Colorado. He takes that one away. It's 1-0. Couillard-Rodak hitting .324 on the year, starting his 18th game, has made the start in every game for Rose-Hulman this season. Curveball just misses, it's 2-0. .420 on base percentage with 10 walks, one of four Rose-Hulman players with double-digit walks on the season. And it misses away, 3-0. Pitch down the middle. Wengler looking to fight back here and get the three up, three down inning. .3-1 misses away, and a two-out walk will put a runner on for the Fighting Engineers and bring up their senior captain, Dalton Busboom. Busboom making just his seventh start this season. But he started every game since coming back from an injury earlier this season. Missed the first 11 games as he was in a walking boot to start the year. But he's come back in full force, hitting .364 through six games. And that curveball in the dirt, it's 1-0. Wengler's got to be careful with Couillard-Rodak over at first. Second on the team in stolen bases as he's 7-for-7. And Busboom gets under that one. He's going to lift it to center field. Bauer underneath. And after one inning of play, scoreless here in Rose-Hulman.
the second inning for the Wabash, the shortstop, number 10, Benjamin Hankey.
Benjamin Hankey leads off the top of the second inning with a first pitch driven to right center field, but a nice play made by Garrett Lloyd, the Terre Haute native out in center field, and there's one down in the inning. That'll bring up the catcher, Evan Nykum, to the dish. Nykum, a junior from Carmel, Indiana, Carmel High School. He takes that one in for strike one. Nykum making just his seventh start of the season as you split time behind the dish for the Little Giants. And that curveball just misses 1-1. One one foul down the right field line off the concession stand, and it's one ball, two strikes. Misses away, count goes to 2-2. Last time between these two teams, it was a pitching duel. Rose-Hulman winning it 6-0, scored 1 in the third, 3 in the fifth, 2 in the sixth. Little Giants recording 5 hits, Rose-Hulman recording 10. As Corey Marlowe picked up the win for the Fighting Engineers, A.J. Reed had the loss for the Little Giants. This one chopped up the middle. Cuyard Rodak charges, throws across his body. Got him at first base. A nice play made by the senior middle infielder. And there's two down in the inning. Nykum was busting down the line, but just not quick enough as Cuyard Rodak was able to make the play. That'll bring up Michael Galanos, the second baseman. He takes the first pitch in there. It's 0-1. Galanos, a junior from Andrean High School, Crown Point, Indiana, up in the region, and he falls behind 0-2 as that one's fouled off. Galanos, another Little Giant that has started every game this season, looking to keep this inning going. The 0-2 pitch, up high, 1-2. Galanos joining A.J. Reed, Camden Scheit, Camden Early, and Reese Bauer as the 5 Little Giants to start all 16 games this season. And this one grounded to the right of Carr. Cuyard Rodak charging, throws across his body again, makes the play. And 3-up, 3-down inning for Rose-Hulman. We head to the bottom of the second. O'Connell, Otrusco, and Rasmussen do up for the Fighting Engineers.
No hits, no errors, with no runners left on base. Do up for the Fighting Engineers, O'Connell, Otrusco, and Rasmussen.
The third baseman, Connor O'Connell, set to lead off the bottom of the second inning for the Fighting Engineers. O'Connell making just his second start at third base on the season. Normally the first baseman, but splitting time with Dalton Busboom. O'Connell went 1-for-3 in the meeting last season, scored a run. And he takes that one for the first pitch strike. Rose-Hulman 8-2 in the last 10 against the Little Giants, including last year's 6-0 victory. Also swept the Little Giants in all three meetings in 2022 with a 7-1 victory here in Terre Haute and 10-3 and 10-4 victories in the end of the season doubleheader in Crawfordsville. O'Connell's going to roll over that one to the right side. It's Galanos making the play, and there's one down. The last two wins for Wabash in the series came back in April 7th of 2019, 4 years ago. They swept the doubleheader in Crawfordsville 11-3 and 12-10 in the two games. The last win for Wabash here at Artneff Field, you got to go all the way back to 21 years ago. April 15th of 2003, it was an 11-8 victory for Wabash. And current head coach Jake Martin hit a home run in that contest for the Little Giants. So a little bit of history there for head coach Martin with one of his three home runs coming against the Fighting Engineers in their last win here at Rose-Hulman. Tyler Otrusco at the plate. It's 1-1. That misses. It's 2-1. Otrusco struggled this season, just 3-for-20 at the plate, making his eighth start in 18 games for Rose-Hulman. And that one misses. It's 3-1. Otrusco just 3 hits, but a couple of extra base hits, had a double and a triple. His triple was in extra innings in the 8-7 victory against Moravian earlier this season, where he was the hero with a triple and the game-winning diving catch in the 10th inning. And he's going to get on for a one-out walk here in the second. Wengler struggling with his command a little bit. 25 pitches, just 11 strikes. Only a 44% strike rate here early on. And Rose-Hulman's team leader in walks coming to the dish now, catcher Mason Rasmussen, hitting sub-200 on the season, just 194, but a 442 on-base percentage because of his 15 walks. And he takes that one on the inside corner. It's 0-1. Otrusco, just one stolen base attempt on the year. He was successful. And Rasmussen swings through that one quickly behind. 2-2. He's been a little prone to the strikeout on the season. 10 strikeouts in his 36 at-bats. It's a whopping 28% strikeout rate. Looking to put one in play here. But he's rung up looking, and the first out of the inning is a strikeout for Nicholas Wengler. 11th strikeout of the season for the catcher Mason Rasmussen. And there's two down in the inning now. That'll bring up the right fielder, Mark Sertanak, hitting 250 on the season, making his 7th start. And that went in the dirt, nice block. Nyken with a good block there to keep Otrusco out of scoring position. Otrusco takes off. Pitch up in the zone, and the throw is going to be into center field. Good job by Bauer to back that one up. But Otrusco in safely for his 2nd stolen base of the season. Rose-Hulman runs quite a bit. Now 29-for-35 on the season. It's an 83% success rate for the Fighting Engineers. That one fouled out of play. Two balls, one strike. Cerdanac just two RBIs on the season. Four singles and a triple for his five hits. That one hits the outside corner, and the count goes to two balls, two strikes. Rosen giving signs here on the 2-2 pitch. This one grounded down the third base line. It stays fair. Otrusco's going to score. Cerdanac in with an RBI single. His third RBI of the season. And Rose-Hulman strikes first here in Terre Haute with a 1-0 lead. Thanks to a Mark Cerdanac RBI single. Reed never had a chance at that one. Just one hop straight past the bag and into left field. And the first hit of the game for Rose-Hulman produces the first run of the game. Garrett Lloyd lays a bunt down. Wangler charging Reed, fields, throws, and he got him at first base for the third out of the inning. Good job by A.J. Reed to call off Wangler as he was going the opposite direction. And after two innings of play, the Fighting Engineers lead 1-0 here on RHIT.TV.
Change for the Fighting Engineers. Now on the mound, number 11, Brad Nardi. Let's go, Nardward. Top of the third inning for the Little Giants, the center fielder, number 4, Reese Bauer.
A new pitcher into the game for Rose-Hulman here as the lineup turns over for the Little Giants. It's the left-handed freshman, Brad Nardi, on the mound, making his fifth appearance of the season. And Bauer's going to foul that one off quickly behind. No balls, two strikes. Nardi, 6 1/3 innings, 5 earned runs, 8 strikeouts, but has walked 8 batters in his 6 1/3, so struggled a little bit with command. Has a 7.11 ERA entering this game. Bauer is going to chop this one to third. O'Connell fields, throws across the diamond, and there's one down. Nardi, a freshman from Avon, Indiana, went to Covenant Christian High School. One of the members, freshman members of this pitching staff. The that has had several freshmen step up, including Brady Strohmeyer, Jackson Summers, Charles Schneider, and Camden Judson. So a lot of freshmen have stepped up in the bullpen for the Fighting Engineers. And this one, Scheit ripping it into left center field. It's going to be down for a one-out single. His second base knock of the ball game. Scheit had one of the longest hitting streaks of the season for the Little Giants at 11 games before his 0-for-5 performance against Greenville midweek last week. But with back-to-back hits, he's now on a four-game hitting streak for the Little Giants. That'll bring up A.J. Reed. Reed was hit by a pitch in his last at-bat. And this one misses up and away, 1-0. Swung on and missed. It's one ball, one strike. A little NCAC history for the Fighting Engineers. Rose-Hulman has played 5 of the 9 teams in the NCAC, including DePaul, Hiram, Ohio Wesleyan, Wabash, and Wittenberg. Have not played games against Oberlin, Denison, Kenyon. This one fouled off. Count stays 1-2. As I mentioned earlier today, Rose-Hulman 8-0 when scoring first. So that run in the second inning bodes well for the Fighting Engineers this season. But a long way from over here on a chilly night at Art Neff Field. And it's going to be a balk on Nardi. Runner's going to move up to second base. Says he did not pause enough on that delivery. And Reed swung on and missed. It's dropped by Rasmussen, but Reed did not run to first. And it looks like Rasmussen and Nardi might have gotten crossed up right there with the runner at second having to change signs. So a good job from the catcher, Mason Rasmussen, to keep that one in front of him for the strikeout. That'll bring up Camden Early. Early struck out swinging in his last at-bat. Hitting 305 on the season. And that one misses up and away. It's 1-0. .391 on base percentage for Early on the season. And it misses, 2-0. The 2-0 misses away. Count goes to 3-0. In there on the outside corner, 3-1. Wabash coming in to this game 8-7 on the year, picked up 2-3 in last week's 3-game series against Illinois Wesleyan. That one fouled out of play, and the count runs full here with two outs in the top of the third inning. So I mentioned Wabash lost 6-5 in the first game of Saturday's doubleheader, came back, won the second game 8-2, and then Illinois Wesleyan made the return trip to Crawfordsville on Sunday, where the Little Giants won the series with an 8-5 victory. The payoff pitch now to Early. In there! Strike three, second strike out of the game for the Little Giants cleanup hitter. And Rose-Hulman gets out of a jam. We head to the bottom of the third inning. Rose-Hulman leading 1-0. Cade Klein set to lead it off here in the bottom of the third inning for Rose-Hulman. Klein struck out swinging in his last at bat, and he chases that high heater. It's 0-1. That was the same pitch he struck out on back in the first. Klein leading the team in nearly every hitting category, .429 batting average, .500 on base percentage, .714 slugging, for a whopping .1214 OPS on the year. But he's struggling with Wengler as he now falls behind. No balls, two strikes. The 0-2 pitch. High heater, it's 1-2. Earlier this season, Klein became the first Rose-Hulman player in school history to hit the cycle in the final game of their spring trip, their 12-5 win over Houghton. The 1-2. In the zone, strike three. Klein goes down looking, his second strikeout of the game.
Stepping up to the plate for the Fine Engineers, the shortstop, number 7, Peter Rogers.
Wengler hasn't been much of a strikeout pitcher, just 9 strikeouts in his 8 innings of work coming in, but 3 strikeouts through 3 here in this ballgame. And the first pitch curveball finds the zone against Peter Rogers. Rogers, the junior shortstop from Merrick, New York, comes in on a 3-game hitting streak. He had his 4-game hitting streak snapped in the first game of Saturday's doubleheader against Mount St. Joseph last weekend. And he's going to rip this one to right field. Gets down fair, and that's going to roll all the way to the corner. Rogers rounding first, heading for second. He's going to be in with a stand-up double here with one out in the third inning. A good job by Camden Early to get to that ball and get it in. A ball like that, a lot of times has triple written all over it, so good job by Early to hold him to 2.
Now batting for Rose-Hulman, the second baseman, number 10, Walter.
And that'll extend Rogers' hit streak and on-base streak to 4 with that double. And that'll bring up Colter Couillard-Rodak. Comes in with the second longest on-base streak on the team this year with 11 straight games getting on base. He takes that one for strike one. And with his walk back in the first inning, he actually extended his on-base streak to 12. The longest on the team this season. But quickly behind, no balls, two strikes here to Wengler. Couillard-Rodak, 22 hits on the year, 3 doubles, 2 triples, an 846 OPS, and he swings and misses for strike 3.
Stepping up to the plate for the Fine Engineers, the first baseman, number 24, Dalton Busboo.
Fourth strikeout of the day for Wengler, and there's 2 down after the double. That'll bring up the first baseman, Dalton Busboom. Busboom with a team-high on-base streak dating back to last season. 37 consecutive games of getting on base. The last time he did not get on base was March 20th, 2023, in a loss to Wisconsin Oshkosh last season. That one misses up. It's 1-1. It was a 1-1 count in the first inning that Busboom flew out to straightaway center field. Wengler looking to strand the one-out double at second base here in the third. That misses low. Count goes to 2-1. Busboom on the season, 8 hits, 4 singles, 3 doubles, and a home run. Hit his home run in the first game of Sunday's doubleheader sweep of the Franklin Grizzlies. A 2-run home run to left field. The Fight Engineers swept the preseason favorite Franklin Grizzlies in that doubleheader to sit atop the HCAC standings at 3-1 through the first weekend of play. A 2-2 up high. The check to second base umpire says he does not go, and the count runs full. Very impossible angle for that field umpire to see. They checked nonetheless, but the count runs full. The payoff pitch now from Nicholas Wengler. Rogers leads off second. The pitch fouled into the Wabash dugout. Lucky everybody's okay in there. The payoff pitch. Misses low and in, and Dalton Busboom extends his on-base streak to 38 consecutive games with the walk. And that'll bring up the sophomore first baseman, Connor O'Connell. O'Connell from Fort Myers, Florida, burst onto the scene with the starting first base job last season and has kept it going here in 2024. He takes that one away, 1-0. O'Connell with a 4-game hit streak. A base knock would tie his career high of 5 games. That one in there, 1-1. That pitch misses way outside in the dirt, gets by the catcher, and the runners will move up to second and third on the wild pitch from Wengler. Now a big opportunity for the Fighting Engineers with runners at second and third and 2 outs in the inning. O'Connell, a .323 hitter on the season, lead second on the team in RBIs with 20. Rogers on third, Busboom on second, 2 outs in the inning. And it's going to miss away. 3 balls, 1 strike. Curveball catches the zone, and the count runs full. Wengler has been very good at, with his command on the season. Just 4 walks coming in. He's already walked 3 batters in 2 1/3, looking to avoid a fourth. The payoff pitch. Curveball in there, swung on and missed. Wengler gets out of the jam, and after 3 innings of play, 1-0 here at Art Neff Field.
Top of the fourth inning for the Little Giants, the designated hitter number 23, William McKenzie.
First pitch grounded to shortstop. High throw from Rogers, but Busboo makes the catch and makes the tag, and there's one down on the first pitch ground out. High throw there from Rogers, but a good athletic play from the first baseman, and there's one down.
The first baseman, number 2, Nick Logan.
That'll bring up the first baseman, Nick Logan. Logan struck out back in the first inning with the bases loaded and 2 outs. Now on to face the lefty, Brad Nardi, who's in for his 2nd inning of work. And that one misses low at 2 balls, no strikes. After the walk, that'll bring up Benjamin Hanke. Hanke's hit safely in 4 consecutive games and has reached base in 7 straight games. Looking to get this rally going here with 1 on and 1 out. But the first pitch strike in there on the outside corner. The 0-2 pitch, grounded to 2nd. Kuyar Rodak flips to short, the turn. Double play number 23 of the season. And after 3.5, Rose-Hulman leads 1-0.
Fourth inning for the Wabash Little Giants. No runs, no hits, no errors, with 1 runner left on base. Due up for the Fighting Engineers, Atrusco, Rasmussen.
Fans, welcome back to Rose-Hulman Baseball here on RHIT.TV. I'm Landon Bundy, and your Fighting Engineers lead it 1-0 here heading into the bottom of the fourth inning of action at Art Neff Field. The first pitch from Wangler misses away. It's 1-0, no strikes. It's a chilly afternoon in Terre Haute, 48 degrees right now, with a feels like a 44 for a typical cool March day in Indiana. And Wangler falls behind, 2-0, no strikes to Otrusco. Otrusco walked and later scored the lone run of the game so far back in the second inning. Scored on Sardinac's single. And that one misses in. The count runs to 3-0, no strikes. Wangler up to 60 pitches now. The 3-0. Right down the middle, count goes to 3-1. That one misses. It'll be a 5-pitch walk. Otrusco reaches with his second walk of the ball game, and Wangler has now doubled his walk count on the season in this game with 4. And that'll bring up Mason Rasmussen, struck out looking on 3 straight pitches back in the second inning. And that one in there, it's 0-1. Rose-Hulman on the year 0-2 when facing a lefty starting pitcher. It's just the third time this season they faced a lefty starter, but yet to come away with a win in those games. But Rasmussen behind quickly 0-2. He's going to pop this one down the right field line. First baseman giving chase, but runs out of room. Stays 0-2. But first time Rasmussen's gotten the bat on the ball on this one. 11 strikeouts on the season, including his back in the second. Wangler looking to get the first out of the inning. Runner takes off. Lined into center field. And it's going to be caught by Bauer. The throw to first. Otrusco back in time. That was a nice little deke by Bauer. Slowed up and didn't have his glove in the air, making it look like that ball was going to drop in front of him. But Otrusco able to get back in time to avoid the double play. And now with 1 down in the inning, Mark Sardinac coming to the plate for the Fighting Engineers. Sardinac, a sophomore from Sagamore Hills, Ohio, Western Reserve High School. That one misses away. It's 1-0. The right fielder drove in the first run of the ball game after an Otrusco walk. Otrusco later stole second and then was singled home by Sardinac. We just saw Otrusco take off on that 0-2 pitch. See if he takes off again in this at bat as Wangler falls behind. 2-0, no strikes. That misses in. It's 3-0. Wangler's last start, he went 5 1/3 innings, gave up 4 earned runs, struck out 7, and threw 90 pitches in last week's midweek loss to Greenville in extra innings. The 3-0 pickoff to first. Otrusco back standing up. So Wangler went 90 pitches in that one. He's at 70. This will be pitch number 70 right now. So he's still got a little wiggle room with this start, but he's got to get out of this jam in a hurry if he wants to be able to finish the fifth inning. The 3-1 pitch to Cerdanak. Atrusco takes off. Ball misses high, and it'll be 2-on with 1 out as the center fielder Garrett Lloyd comes to the dish. Wangler's 5th walk of the ball game. Wabash just 3-6 when allowing their opponents to score first on the season, as they have in this one. And also just 1-2 away from home. This is only their 3rd day traveling, as they split last weekend's doubleheader at Illinois Wesleyan. And then lost 8-7 in 10 innings against Greenville in last week's midweek contest. So Garrett Lloyd coming to the dish now, bunted in his last at bat, was thrown out by A.J. Reed at first. He's going to take the first pitch for a strike. Good mound visit by the pitching coach to calm Wangler down after back-to-back walks put 2 on for Rose-Hulman. That one catches the outside corner quickly. No balls, 2 strikes. Garrett Lloyd, .300 batting average on the season. Just his 4th start of the year. 3-11. So down to .272 batting average after the first out. The pickoff to second. Not in time. And it's going to be a balk called on the freshman southpaw. And just like that, runners at 2nd and 3rd with 1 out. And head coach Jake Martin coming out to have a word with the second base umpire about what he saw there with the balk. Jake Martin, a career 312-252 record, was at DePauw for 7 years before coming here to Wabash. Now it is 8th year as the Wabash head coach. Now the 0-2 to Lloyd misses away. That's 1-2. Jake Martin has a career record of 7-12 against the Fighting Engineers, while second year head coach Adam Rosen for Rose-Hulman, a 4-0 record against the Little Giants. Infield in now with 1 away. The 1-2 pitch. Misses low. Count goes to 2-2. Lloyd's been prone to the strikeout this season. 4 strikeouts in his 11 at-bats. The 2-2. Curveball swung on and missed. Strike 3. 2nd out of the inning. A big out for Wangler. And that'll bring up the leadoff hitter, the designated hitter, Cade Klein. Klein 0-2 with a couple of strikeouts against Wangler today, but by far the best hitter on this team, leading the team with 22 RBIs on the season. That fastball misses away, it's 1-0. This is one of those decisions that you wouldn't be surprised to see an intentional walk, but after he hasn't looked great in his 2 at-bats with a couple of strikeouts, you're definitely having Wangler pitch to him here. The 1-0 misses up. 2 balls, no strikes to Klein. Now 2-0. You got to be careful not to give him too good of a pitch to hit, as he can make this game 3-0 with just a simple base knock. That's in there on the outside corner. Great spot by Wangler. He's really lit up that outside corner all night. Otrusco on third, Serdanac on second, two outs in the inning. Klein's going to ground this one right side. Fielded by Galanos, throws to first, and Wengler gets out of the jam after four innings of play. 1-0, Rose-Hulman leads.
No runs, no hits, no errors, with two runners left on base. Two up for the Little Giants, Nykum, Galanos, and Bauer. Pitching change for Rose-Hulman. Now on the mound, number 43, Brett Borcherding. The top of the fifth inning for the Little Giants, the catcher number 14, Evan Nykum.
Evan Nykum set to lead off the top of the fifth inning for the Little Giants against new Rose-Hulman pitcher, Brett Borcherding. Borcherding was my projected starter on the night. He comes in relief here in the fifth. On the season, making just his third appearance, has started both other games, but has gone just 6 1/3 innings total. Six earned runs, seven walks. So struggles with his command. But he gets ahead quickly here against Nykum, 1-2. The 1-2 pitch from Borcherding. Curveball grounded in between short and third, and it'll be the third base hit of the game for Wabash. That was a play. Connor O'Connell went to his left, was unable to get the short hop, goes into left field, and Nykum on with a leadoff single. Then I bring up the second baseman, Michael Galanos. O'Connell playing in for the bunt, and Galanos does square, but pulls back and takes strike one. Galanos on the season, hitting .328 coming in. He squares the bunt once again. He's going to get it down. Two hops over to O'Connell, and the throw to first, and there's a one down. Good heads-up play there by Borcherding to get over to third base.
Now batting the center fielder, number four, Reese Bauer.
But a sack bunt from Galanos moves the tying run into scoring position. For the top of the order, Reese Bauer to the dish. Bauer also going to square this one in the dirt. It's 0-1. Bauer hitting just 281 coming in, 0-2 on the day. Struck out in the first, grounded to third in the third. The 1-0 lined into right center field. This one's going to get down, and that's going to tie the game for Wabash. And it's going to be a one-out double for Reese Bauer. And just like that, this ball game tied up.
Now batting left fielder number 18, Camden Scheit.
And that'll bring up Camden Scheit, 2-for-2 on the day. Scheit's hit a pair of singles, one into right center, one into left center. This one sawed off, one hop over to O'Connell, and throws over to first for the second out of the inning. Got sawed off right on the hands there. And now with two down, A.J. Reed coming to the dish, the third baseman. Reed coming in, hitting 400 on the season with runners on base. But he swings and misses through that one. 6-for-18 with runners in scoring position. That's what's led to his 13 RBIs. Bauer dancing off second base there. Trying to get in Borcherding's head. Bauer just 2-for-5 on stolen base attempts on the season as that one's fouled off. No balls, two strikes to Reed. The 0-2 pitch. Dribbled in front of home. And it's going to be just in front of home plate. Rasmussen makes the play. Reed arguing that it bounced behind home plate, but it does not touch the catcher. Bounces behind home, comes back fair. And that'll be the third out of the inning. Heads up the play there by Mason Rasmussen. And we head to the bottom of the fifth inning, 1-1 here at Art Neff Field.
fifth inning for the Fighting Engineers, the shortstop.
Wangler coming back out of the mound to start the fifth inning. 80 pitches for the freshman southpaw, and he's going to face 2-3-4 in the order for the Fighting Engineers with the game tied at 1. That fastball misses. It's 1-0. Wabash got that run back in the fifth inning to tie up the ball game on a Nykum single and a Bauer double. And now Rogers leading it off. Curveball in the dirt, 2-0. Rogers tied his season-high hit streak of 4 games with his double. And he takes that one for a strike. Had a one-out double back in the third, but was stranded at second. The 2-1 pitch now to the shortstop. He's going to lift this one out of play. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Rose-Hulman comes in on a 3-game winning streak. Took the second game of Saturday's doubleheader against Mount St. Joseph before sweeping Franklin on Sunday. Also a 1-game winning streak here on their home turf after beating Greenville on Wednesday. And that one misses up and away. Count runs full. The payoff pitch from Wangler. Misses up and away. That's going to be ball 4. Leadoff batter reaches for Rose-Hulman for the second time in this ballgame. Second consecutive inning, it's been a leadoff walk for the Fighting Engineers after a Trusco walked back in the fourth. Now Cougar Rodak comes to the dish, walked and struck out in his 2 appearances. This is misses away, 1-0. Wangler up to 87 pitches, his career high 90 last week, as I mentioned. We'll see how much longer he goes into this ballgame. That misses up and away, 2-0. 7 or 8 pitches now this inning, 6 balls. And a good call here by Nykum to go out and calm down his freshman pitcher. Free passes always kill, and walking 2 straight batters to lead off an inning almost never ends well for the opposition. Cuyard Rodak second on the team in several categories, 15 runs scored, 22 hits, third with 15 RBIs. Big chance here. Rogers leads off first, the 2-0. In there on the outside part of the plate, 2 balls, 1 strike. And this will be pitch number 90 for the freshman southpaw. Runner takes off. Ball in the dirt, and that's going to be a stolen base for Peter Rogers. And the count goes to 3-1 for Cuyard Rodak. Peter Rogers, just his second stolen base of the season, 2 for 2 now on the year. And Cuyard Rodak with a big opportunity. Hitters count 3-1 and a man in scoring position. He's going to chop this one left side. Off the third baseman, the throw not in time, hit off the mid of the third baseman Reed. Rogers took off running and Reed tried to do a swipe tag but did not field the ball in time, and that'll be an error on the third baseman to put runners on the corners, nobody out. First error of the ball game. And now back to the mound comes the pitching coach. It's not the head coach, Jake Martin, so I don't expect there to be a change here. But runners on the corners, nobody out. A big opportunity for the Fighting Engineers to get back in front after giving up the lead in the top of the inning. Continuing to look at some series history between these two teams. These two teams have been playing for a long time. Rose-Hulman leading the all-time series 71-60. 133rd all-time meeting between these two teams, with the first coming back in 1889. Rose-Hulman winning 12-0 in 1889. Wabash picked up their first win of the series in 1900 with an 8-6 victory. So over 135 years of history between these two ball clubs. And the first pitch misses inside. It's 1-0 to Dalton Busboom. Slight wind blowing out to dead center field. Couillard Rodak on first. The pitch fouled out of play. 1-1. Rogers on third, Couillard Rodak on second. We saw the second baseman steal earlier today. He's 7-for-7 on stolen bases this season. See if he takes off here with nobody out in the fifth. This one chopped to third. Reed fields, throws home. Rogers out in plenty of time. And the first out of the inning recorded. Rosen throws his head back. You're going on contact in that situation unless it's hit to the pitcher or the third baseman. But Rogers goes nonetheless, and he's retired at the plate. And a big out for Nicholas Wangler. Takes the runner off third base. And that'll bring up Connor O'Connell. O'Connell grounds this one right side through into right field. Early coming up throwing. Couillard Rodak to the plate, and he's going to score. Rose-Hulman retakes the lead. Connor O'Connell with the RBI single. And now that's going to be it for the freshman southpaw, Nicholas Wangler, as head coach Jake Martin comes out and calls to the bullpen. We'll be back in just a moment here on RHIT.TV.
Change for the Little Giants. Now on the mound, number 13, Gavin Pearson.
A good pitching outing there from the freshman Nicholas Wangler. Ends 95 pitches, goes 4 1/3 innings, giving up just 3 hits, 2 runs, only one of them earned, and striking out 6. Did have 6 walks, but those not coming back to hurt him too much. As the first run back in the second inning was a walk, a stolen base, and a single. The one in the fifth inning unearned as Couillard Rodak reached on the air by the third baseman. But Rose-Hulman leading 2-1 here in the bottom of the fifth inning. It'll be another southpaw on the mound for the Little Giants, number 13, Gavin Pearson, a junior from Brownsburg, Indiana. Pearson on the year making his 6th appearance, gone 14 2/3 innings, 12 earned runs, 8 strikeouts, 9 walks, with a 7.36 ERA. His last appearance came over the weekend, the second game against Illinois Wesleyan. his best outing of the season by far, as he went 3 1/3 innings of shutout baseball and picked up his first save of the year. And he's on to face Tyler Otrusco here with one out in the fifth inning. First pitch in the dirt, ball one. This one fouled straight back, counts one ball, one strike. As I mentioned, Otrusco walked and scored back in the second inning. He also led off the fourth inning with a walk, so 0-for-0 with a couple of trips on base for the right-hander. Now a three-game on-base streak, tying his career high, getting the most playing time of his career this season. But he falls behind, one ball, two strikes. Swung on and missed strike three. Second out of the inning recorded by Pearson. And that'll bring up the catcher, Mason Rasmussen. Rasmussen 0-for-2 on the day, struck out and flew out to center field in his two at-bats. Making his 13th start in 18 games for the Fighting Engineers. Came in just hitting 194 after his 0-for-2 start in this one. Batting average down to 184 for the sophomore catcher. But quickly ahead in the count, two balls, no strikes. Should get a good pitch to hit here as Rose-Hulman looks to tack on a couple runs here with a 2-1 lead in the fifth. So one lifted high into right field, but it's going to get out of the play into the Little Giant bullpen. 2-1. In the dirt, three balls, one strike to Rose-Hulman catcher Rasmussen. Rasmussen from Lake Barrington, Illinois, went to Barrington High School just on the northwest side of Chicago. A 3-1 pitch. Fouled off. It count runs full. Well, base hit here. Shirley scores Busboom from second base as the runners will be going on the pitch. It's Busboom on second, O'Connell on first. Infield shifted majorly to the left side, expecting Rasmussen to pull here. Runners go inside, ball four, and the bases will be loaded for Mark Serdanak, who brought in the first run with a single down the left field line back in the second inning. Third consecutive inning, the Fighting Engineers have runners in scoring position. Serdanak looking to extend this lead with his second hit of the ball game. Pearson misses away. It's one ball, no strikes. Serdanak just two multi-hit games on the season. Six in his career, looking to make that seven with a knock here. But he swings and misses through that curveball way out in front. The 1-1 pitch from Pearson. In the dirt, 2-1. In there on the outside corner, and the count goes to 2-2. Pearson looking for his second strikeout of the inning, his 10th of the game. Bases loaded, two outs. The pitch to Serdinak. Swung on and missed, strike three. Pearson gets out of the jam. And after five innings of play, Rose-Hulman leads it 2-1 here at Art Neff Field.
For the bottom of the fifth inning for the Fine Engineers, one run scored on one hit, one error with three runners left on base. Due up for the Little Giants, Early, McKenzie, and Logan.
Getting in on some other scores across the Heartland Collegiate Athletic Conference. Bluffton was in action hosting the Baldwin Wallace Yellow Jackets earlier today, but fell 15-7 to the OAC foe. Manchester pulled out a 10-8 victory against Hope. Gave up four in the first inning, but battled back with seven straight runs and was able to hold on for the victory. Early leading off the top of the sixth inning now, 0-for-2 with a couple of strikeouts, and he's down one ball, two strikes. Borcherding still on the mound for Rose-Hulman here in the sixth. So that fastball misses up, it's two balls, two strikes. That one fouled straight back. Early stays alive. Just like last year, settled into a pitcher's duel here at Art Neff Field. Last year, just 15 hits combined between the two teams. We're at 7 through 5 innings here in this one. The 2-2, grounded left side. Rogers fields on the hop, throws the first one down in the inning. That'll bring up Will McKenzie, 0-for-1, grounded out to shortstop back in the fourth and walked in the first. McKenzie's hit safely in his last four games, including a multi-hit performance in the second game of the doubleheader against Illinois Wesleyan on Saturday. Has also had RBIs in four consecutive games for the Little Giants. The 0-1 pitch from Borcherding. Misses high, 1-1. This one fouled out of play, and it's one ball, two strikes. McKenzie started nearly every game this season, missing just one. Comes in hitting .283 with 13 hits, seven of which for extra bases. The 1-2 driven into right field. Serdinak on his run to his right. He's going to field off two bounces, and McKenzie is going to be in with a one-out single. McKenzie hits safely in his fifth consecutive game. And that'll bring up Nick Logan, the first baseman. Struck out in the first, walked in the fourth in his two appearances. Logan had a three-hit performance in game one of their doubleheader against Hanover. This is just his second game since then in 10 days. Hitting 350 on the year with runners on. He's going to chop this to short. The flip to second, throw on to first. Double play number 24 for the Fighting Engineers. Ranked top five in the country for a reason, and they do it again today. We head to the bottom of the sixth inning. Rose-Hulman leading 2-1. Back to action here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Rose-Hulman turns their second double play of the game up to 24 on the year, which is ranked third in the country, trailing only McMurray and Barry College. So Rose-Hulman's defense very good at getting ground ball outs and turning them into double plays. Back to action here in the bottom of the sixth. It's Garrett Lloyd, the nine-hole hitter, leading it off for the Fighting Engineers. Pearson still on the mound for the Little Giants. And Lloyd's going to rip this first pitch into right center field, and it's going to be tracked down by the center fielder, Reese Bauer, for the first out of the inning.
Next up for Rose-Hulman, the designated hitter, number 30, Cade Klein.
That'll bring up the top of the order for the Fighting Engineers, Cade Klein, 0-3 on the day. As that one misses in, one ball, one no strikes. Klein comes in with a team-high 18-game hitting streak, longest in his career. Also an 18-game on-base streak for the junior from Terre Haute, Indiana. And that one misses, two balls, no strikes. Klein's hit safely in 16 of our 17 games this season. He fouls this one back. Two balls, one strike. The only game Klein has not hit safely in was a seven-inning game against Grove City, which was the quickest game I've ever been a part of. An hour and 7 minutes in the first game of our doubleheader. A 2-1 game in which the first four innings were played in 35 minutes. Klein ahead now 3-1 to Pearson. This one in the dirt, ball four. Klein extends his on-base streak to 12. And a runner on with one out here in the sixth inning.
Stepping up
That'll bring up Peter Rogers, 1-for-2 on the day, doubled in the third, walked in the fifth, but was thrown out at the plate there on that first third situation with nobody out in the last inning. Rogers rips this one into left field. Left fielder going back, and Camden Scheidt's going to make the catch. Nice play by the left fielder for the second out of the inning. That'll bring up the second baseman, Coulter Couillard Rodak. Rodak coming in 0-for-2 on the day, walked in the first, reached on an error in the fifth, and later scored the second run of the game. This has been an infield-heavy day for the Little Giants. Just 4 fly ball outs, with 2 of which coming this inning. So outfield not having a lot of work so far, but a couple of nice plays there by Scheidt and Bauer for the first 2 outs of this inning. Out and misses away, 1-ball, 1-strike. Wabash needs to be careful with Klein over at first base, leading the team with 8 stolen bases on the season. Throw over to first, not in time. His 8 stolen bases ranked 5th in the conference coming into the game. The 1-1 pitch to Couillard Rodak. Misses high, 2-1. Swung on and missed that one almost in the dirt, and it's 2 balls, 2 strikes here in the bottom of the 6th inning. Klein leads off first. Takes off the curveball in there, struck him out looking, and that'll end the inning after 6 innings of play. Rose-Hulman leading it 2-1 as we head to the 7th.
Top of the 7th inning for Wabash, the shortstop, number 10, Benjamin Hankey.
Yeah.
Tyler Orr, the new pitcher into the ballgame for Rose-Hulman. And he's on to face Benjamin Hanke. And gets ahead quickly. No balls. Two strikes. This one popped out of play down the first base line. That one just misses the outside corner, 1-2. Another curveball misses away, stays 2 balls, 2 strikes. Orr on the season, making his team high 7th appearance, has gone 1 inning per out inning, 2 earned runs, 2 walks, 5 strikeouts in 6 innings, and 0-2 to 3-2. 3 straight balls missing away. Good job by Hanke working the count as he looks to extend his hit streak. That misses away, ball 4. Hanke reaches base safely for his 8th consecutive game. And more importantly, leadoff batter on for the Little Giants. Just the second time this game that Wabash has had the leadoff runner reach base. Newcomb singled back in the 5th and later scored. So good omen for Wabash here with the leadoff batter on. Newcomb's going to square to bunt. Bunt him over to second base, and there's 1 out in the inning. And just like in the 5th inning, leadoff batter on, sack bunt. And now the tying run in scoring position for Michael Galanos. Galanos had a sack bunt back in the 5th and grounded out to 2nd in the 2nd. And he fouls the first pitch out of play. It's 0-1. Galanos on the year hitting .308 with runners in scoring position. 8 for 26. That slider misses high. It's 1-1. Galanos also hitting .341 with runners in scoring position. And that one, pick off to 2nd. Not in time. Despite those good numbers with runners on and runners in scoring position, just 6 RBIs on the season for Galanos. Has 20 hits, 19 of them singles, only 1 extra base hit. But a single should do the job here to tie this ball game up. That slider catches the inside corner. 1 ball, 2 strikes. Hanke leads off 2nd. The 1-2 popped out of play. Good job by Galanos to stay alive. That was the same exact pitch he just watched catch the inside corner. Wasn't going to see that 2 times in a row. Rosen telling the center fielder to take a couple of steps in. They want to be able to throw Hanke out at the plate on a single. But Galanos staying alive. Count stays 1 ball, 2 strikes. The pitch lined into left center field, and it's going to get down for an RBI single. Galanos throws on the brakes, but he does the job. His 7th RBI of the season, and this game tied up once again 2-2. Same exact formula they used in the 5th. Leadoff batter on, sack bunt, RBI. And this game knotted up at 2-2 here in the 7th. With the top of the Wabash order coming to the dish. Just the 3rd earned run given up on the season for Tyler Orr. And now he's got a job to do facing the tough part of this Wabash order. Bunt out in front of home plate. And it's going to hit off the catcher. Nobody covering 3rd. And it's going to be... And it's going to be an error on the catcher, Mason Rasmussen. And the runner's going to advance to third. Heads up base running by Galanos. That'll go down as a sack bunt and an error on the catcher to put runners on the corners with one out. With Camden Scheit coming to the dish with a chance to put Wabash in front here in the seventh inning. Scheit 2-for-3 on the day, singled in the first, singled in the third, grounded out in the fifth. That misses low, 2-0. Or needing to find the strike zone here. A ground ball could get the Fighting Engineers out of it. Scheit rips this one into right field. It's going to get over the head of Mark Serdanak up against the wall. Two runs are going to score. Scheit on his way to third. The throw not in time, and it's a two-run triple for Camden Scheit, and Wabash has their first lead of the day. 4-2. And now pitching coach Ryan Caveney coming out to have a little chat with Orr. Three runs for the Little Giants in the inning to take their first lead of the ball game. Wabash on the season just 1-5 when trailing after six innings. While Rose-Hulman 8-0 when leading after six innings. So a big three-run rally here in the seventh and another run just 90 feet away. Big chance for Wabash to tack on some insurance runs here with three innings left to play. This will bring up A.J. Reed to the dish. Reed, 400 hitter with runners in scoring position. And he's going to be hit by the pitch. First pitch after the mound visit is a hit by pitch. And it'll be runners on the corners with one down. Camden Early coming to the dish now, 0-for-3 on the day, couple of strikeouts and a ground out to shortstop. Rose-Hulman shift heavy pull here. Peter Rogers playing almost straight up the middle with a huge hole on the backside. This one going to be popped into left field. Otrusco coming on, he's going to make the catch. Runner breaking for the plate. And it's going to be a sacrifice fly. That'll be an RBI for Early to extend the lead to 5-2. Pick off to first, not in time. McKenzie pops this one out of play down the first base line. It's 0-1. Correction, 1-1. Tough outing here for Tyler Orr as he's given up four runs, two of them unearned after the error on the sack bunt by the catcher Mason Rasmussen. This one fouled straight back, one ball, two strikes. The 1-2 pitch. Runner takes off stealing, and it's fouled out of play. We'll do it over again. Reed 4-for-5 on stolen bases this year. See if he takes off again on the 1-2. Runner stays put. Ball misses low. 2-2. Reed steals the 2-2, driven into right center field, and it's going to get down. Lloyd bobbles. Reed being sent home, the throw to the plate. Not in time. And a second Rose-Hulman error will allow Wabash to extend the lead to 6-2. And that's going to be it for Tyler Orr as Adam Rosen out to make the pitching change. We'll be back in a moment with the new pitcher here on RHIT.TV.
Change for Rose-Hulman. Now on the mound, number 29, Skyler Wilcox.
New arm into the game for Rose-Hulman is Skyler Wilcox. Wilcox, a senior from Centennial, Colorado, Eagle Crest High School. And a first pitch to Logan is fouled straight back. It's 0-1. Logan grounds this one to third. It's going to get past Connor O'Connell. That's going to be the third error of the inning for the Fighting Engineers. And it'll be runners at the corners for Benjamin Hanke. Hanke led off this inning for a walk and scored the tying run. He's going to chop this one foul, 0-1. Skylar Wilcox on the year, making his team-high appearance 7, 2-0 with a 2.79 ERA, just 3 earned runs allowed in 9 and 2/3 innings. That one fouled out of play. It's 0-2. Just 4 walks and 4 strikeouts on the air for Wilcox. The 0-2 pitch now to Hanke. He's going to chop this one right side, fielded by Kuyard Rodak, out recorded. The Little Giants tack on 5 on 3 Rose-Hulman errors. We head to the bottom of the 7th inning, Wabash leading 6-2. Other events to come here on RHIT.TV this week. The Rose-Hulman softball team hosts Greenville University tomorrow in a 2-game doubleheader. They play at 5 p.m. and 7 p.m. Then on Saturday, we have 2 spring games. Our men's soccer team will have their alumni game at 2 p.m. on Saturday. And our volleyball team will host IU Northwest at 1 p.m. All of those games can be seen live right here on RHIT.TV. Dalton Busboom leading off the bottom of the 7th inning for Rose-Hulman, and he falls quickly behind. No balls, 2 strikes. Gavin Pearson still on the mound for the Little Giants, as he's now in line for the win after the 5-run inning for Wabash. The 0-2 misses away. It's 1-2. Pearson has struggled with his command on the season, but he's been locked down here today. Busboom's going to ground this over to third. It's going to kick off the heel of the glove by Reed, and it's going to be an error on the third baseman, his second error of the ball game. And Rose-Hulman has the leadoff runner on as they look to come back, trailing 6-2. Connor O'Connell now 1-for-3 on the day, singled in the 5th inning. Was the last batter that the starting pitcher faced before Pearson came into the ballgame. And Pearson's first pitch misses. It's 1-0. That curveball in for strike one. He's got the big looping sweeper, and it's kept Rose-Hulman on their toes as they see that ball high out of his hand, and it just drops right into the strike zone. He's had a couple of strikeouts on that pitch, and back-to-back curveballs in. It's 1-2. The Fighting Engineers really not seeing that curveball well at all today. The 1-2 pitch. Fastball up high. Great pitch sequence there by Pearson. You go back-to-back curveballs in the zone. O'Connell's going to be expecting that. You go high heater, and he just laid off. Now count runs to 2-2. Curveball once again hits it the other way. Fielded by Reed. The throw across the diamond. And a great stop by the third baseman to keep that in front and retire O'Connell. Trusco yet to put the ball in play in this one. 0 for 1, 2 walks and a strikeout. Struck out as the first batter that Pearson faced back in the fifth inning. And he gets ahead. No balls, one strike. The 0-1 to Trusco. No balls, two strikes. This one popped down the right field line. It'll get out of play into the parking lot. Still 0-2. Pearson's done a great job attacking the strike zone. He was struggling early on through his first 20 pitches. He threw just 8 strikes, but he's really battled back. 39 pitches, 23 strikes now for the southpaw. That one does miss away. It's 1-2. The junior from Brownsburg deals. Swung, fouled straight back. Stays 1-2. Trusco staying alive in the at-bat as Rose-Hulman down to their final 8 outs here at Art Neff Field. The 1-2. Chopped right side. Second baseman charges. And the out's retired. 2 outs in the inning. And that'll bring up Mason Rasmussen, the catcher. 0 for 2 on the day. Did walk back in the fifth inning against Pearson. Rasmussen hitting just 184 on the season. Looking for a base hit to cut this deficit down to 3. Keep Rose-Hulman in the ballgame. And he swings through that fastball. It's 0-1. Fastball misses high. 1 ball, 1 strike. Again, Wabash looking for their first win in Terre Haute in 21 years. Last win coming in 2003. And that one in the dirt. Nice block by the catcher, Nykum. Rasmussen did not play against Wabash last season. That was 0 for 2 in his career against the Little Giants. The 2-1 pitch. Popped up right side. Fouled ground. Drifting, and it's going to be caught by the first baseman. Nick Logan making the catch in foul territory. We head to the eighth inning. Little Giants leading 6-2.
We head to the top of the eighth inning here in Terre Haute. Skyler Wilcox still on the mound for the Fighting Engineers. Evan Nykum, the catcher, leading off. 1-for-2 on the day, singled and scored back in the fifth inning. Nykum grounds this right side, it through for a leadoff single into right field. And the leadoff batter on for the third time. The leadoff batter has scored both of the other two times for Wabash. Rose-Hulman will look to keep them off the board and keep this game in contention here in the eighth inning. Michael Galanos singled and scored. He squares, takes that one on the inside corner, strike one. It's been rinse and repeat for Wabash. Both times they got the leadoff batter on, it's been a sack bunt for the next batter. We'll see if Galanos squares once again. Does not, and it's on the inside corner. No balls, two strikes. Wilcox attacking the zone. 9 pitches, 9 strikes. The 0-2. Just misses inside. Tried to go the same spot, and it'll be 1 ball, 2 strikes. Nykum on first. The pickoff over to first had Nykum leaning towards second, but gets back safely. The 1-2 swung on and missed strike three. And the first out of the inning recorded for Wilcox.
Now batting for Wabash, the center fielder, number 4, Reese Bauer.
That'll bring up the top of the order, Reese Bauer to the dish. 1-for-4 on the day, reached on an error on the catcher on his sack bunt, his last at bat, and squares once again, but fouls it. Struck out in the first, grounded out to third, and his lone hit, the double, back in the fifth inning to bring home the first run of the game for the Little Giants. That one fouled down the first base line, out of play. It's no balls, 2 strikes. Bauer hitting just 194 on the season with no runners or with runners on base. That one misses away. Good block by Rasmussen. Chopped foul. Count stays 1-2. That one in on the hands, fouled off once again. Good at bat here by Bauer to stay alive. Fouled out of play once again. 7th pitch of the at-bat upcoming for Reese Bauer as he has battled here in the count. The 1-2 pitch. In the dirt, 2-2. Great job by Bauer working this count, making Wilcox really work on the mound. The 2-2 pitch. Lifted into left field. Otrusco coming in. He's going to make the catch for the second out of the inning. Looking at what's upcoming for these two ball clubs. On Saturday, Wabash will travel to number 6 Denison. Or correction, they will host number 6 Denison in a doubleheader to open NCAC play at 12 p.m. and 3 p.m. in Crawfordsville. For Rose-Hulman, they continue HCAC play this weekend with a 3-game series in Lexington. 7 p.m. on Friday for the opener against the Transylvania Pioneers for a couple of games at 1 p.m. and 4 p.m. on Saturday. That one catches the outside corner. It's one ball, one strike to Cam Scheidt. With Scheidt's three hits today, that one fouled off. He's now hit safely in 15 of 16 games this season. He was 0-for-5 in last Tuesday's extra inning loss to Greenville, but he has hits in 15 of 16 games to start this year. Pick off over to first, not in time. One, two, misses away. Count goes to 2-2. And the count runs full. Nykum will be off on the pitch here. 3-2, two outs to Camden Scheidt. If he puts a ball in the gap like he did last time, Wabash could tack on another run. The 3-2 pitch popped out of play. Pitch number 7 upcoming in the at-bat. Back-to-back long at-bats for the Little Giants, really making Wilcox work here in the 8th. The payoff pitch, driven down the right field line. It's going to get just foul. With Nykum off and running, that almost certainly would have scored him from first base, but the count stays full. The all-time series history between these two teams, Rose-Hulman leads it 71-60 with one tie. In 1985, the two teams tied 9-9 in Crawfordsville. Field with no lights, so I'm guessing the tie was due to darkness. But the payoff pitch once again here in the 8th misses away. It'll be a two-out walk, and the Little Giants will have runners at first and second with two outs. And that'll be it for Skylar Wilcox as Adam Rosen comes to the mound. We'll have a new pitcher in just a moment. We'll be right back on RHIT.TV.
Pitching change for Rose-Hulman. Now on the mound, number 18, Evan Chung. Stepping up to the plate for Wabash, the third baseman, number 42, A.J. Reed.
Evan Chung, the new arm into the game for Rose-Hulman. Chung pitched two innings in last year's contest against the Little Giants. Did not allow a base runner in those two innings, but he starts this one off with a first pitch in the dirt, and the runners will advance to second and third with two outs. Chung struggled a little bit on the season. A 6.14 ERA in his four appearances, 7 1/3 innings, 7 walks to just 2 strikeouts for the righty. But that one catches the outside corner. It's 1-1. Chung, a sophomore from Lake Zurich, Illinois, came on strong as one of the top arms in the Rose-Hulman bullpen last season, but has gotten off to a tough start here in his sophomore year. Quickly ahead now, 1-2 to Reed. Reed, a 400 hitter with runners on base, looking to extend this lead. That one misses low, 2-2. Reed just missed hitting for the cycle in last Tuesday's game, had a single, triple, and home run, and it's hit a foul ball down the left field line that just missed being a double by about 6 feet. And he's worked the count to 3-2 now. Oh for 2 in the game with a pair of hit-by-pitches. And he's worked the count full with 2 outs in the 8th. And he fouls that one off. The Little Giants doing an excellent job this inning at working the count. This is the 3rd 7-plus pitch at bat of the inning. And they walk him. Base is loaded for Camden Early. Early, the only Wabash player yet to reach base in the ballgame. 0-3, couple of strikeouts, a ground out to short, and a sack fly in the 7th inning. And the count goes to 1-0. And that one misses away, 2 balls, no strikes. Chung has struggled with his command this year. 8 walks in just 6 innings pitched. And that one catches the corner, 2-1. Early can really put this ball game out of reach with a base hit here. Grounds right side. It's through for a base hit. Serdinak charging. The throw to the plate is cut off. And it's a 2-run single for the Little Giants as they extend the lead to 8-2. That'll bring up William McKenzie to the plate. 2-3 on the day, couple of singles in the 6th and 7th inning. And he swings through that one. It's 0-1. And McKenzie lines this one to center field, caught by Lloyd. We head to the bottom of the 8th inning. Wabash leading 8-2.
Thank you.
New pitcher into the game for Wabash is number 37, Dylan Hazlett, sophomore from Indianapolis, Indiana, and Cathedral High School. And he misses in for ball one. To the sophomore, Mark Serdanak. That one hits Serdanak in the back, and Rose-Hulman will have the leadoff runner on with the hit-by-pitch.
Stepping up to the plate for the Fight Engineers, the center fielder, number 5, Derek Lloyd.
Derek Lloyd coming to the plate now, 0-3 on the day, grounded out to third, struck out, and flew out to center field. Lloyd, the only Rose-Hulman batter to not reach base on the day, and he's going to chop this one up the middle. The flip to second, throw on to first, and he beats it out. And Lloyd will reach on the fielder's choice. Now Cade Klein stepping to the dish, looking to extend his hit streak to 12 games, 0-3 with a walk so far today. And it's going to be time called for the catcher prior to the pitch. And it looks like this is just going to be no pitch. So the first pitch to Klein misses for ball one. The 1-0. It's going to be behind Klein. It's going to go all the way to the backstop, and Lloyd moves up to second base. Curveball started in and just went more in as Klein had to jump out of the way of that one. And it'll be two balls, no strikes. That one fouled straight back out of play, 2-1. Fastball catches the outside corner. Two balls, two strikes. Hazlett ahead in the count. The 2-2 pitch. Swung on and missed strike three. Klein goes down for the third time today. And there's two outs in the inning. Tough day at the plate for the Rose-Hulman leadoff hitter. Just as 0-4 will snap his 11-game hitting streak, assuming he does not come up again in the ninth inning on a Rose-Hulman rally. Now Peter Rogers to the dish, 1-3, a double and a walk, and that catches the outside corner for strike one. Hazlett on the season, 13 innings, 13 strikeouts. A 3.46 ERA. And he's mowing the hitters down here in the eighth. That fastball misses up. It's 1-1. Runner in scoring position for Rogers as he comes in hitting 217 on the season. 8 extra base hits with his 8 singles. And it's 2-1. Fastball misses in. 3 balls, 1 strike to the junior shortstop from Merrick, New York. As Rose-Hulman looks to keep a rally going here, trailing by 6 runs down to their final 4 outs of the game. A 3-1 pitch is going to catch the inside corner. Count runs full. The payoff pitch from Hazlitt checks the runner at second. He throws. This is in the dirt. Ball's going to get to the backstop, and Lloyd will move up to third base. And Rogers will reach for the third time today with his second walk. And that'll bring up Coulter Couillard-Rodak, 0-3. Reached on a walk in the first inning and an error in the fifth. Also has a pair of strikeouts. Wabash giving their first third sign. Rogers stole a base back in the fifth inning in his first walk. Just his second stolen base of the season. As Couillard-Rodak stands in. That one in the dirt, ball one. Wouldn't expect Rogers to be taken off here. Down 6 runs, you don't want to run into any outs. And that'll bring the pitching coach out of the dugout to have a little chat with the Wabash infield. The next home game for the Fighting Engineers is a ways away to next weekend, as they will host Bluffton in a 3-game series. First game on Saturday will be at 3 p.m., so a late start. Their doubleheader will be at 3 p.m. and 6 p.m. against the Beavers on April 6th. The weekend after that, they will host Earlham College in a doubleheader on Saturday. So doubleheaders 3 weekends in a row for the Fighting Engineers. On April 6th, 13th, and 20th upcoming. Back to action now. 1 ball, no strikes to Couillard-Rodak. And the curveball is going to miss in. It's 2-0. That one catches the outside corner. A nice frame there by Nykum. And it's 2-1. And that one fouled out of play. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Couillard-Rodak looking to extend his season-high hit streak to 6 with a base knock. As Rose-Hulman has been held to just 3 hits in the ballgame, has just 1 hit since the second inning of action. Not fouled out of play. Mark Cerdanak singled home a run in the second. They'd have a double from Peter Rogers in the third and a single from O'Connell in the fifth. So just 1 hit in the last 5 innings for the Fighting Engineers. The 2-2 pitch. Swung on and missed, strike 3. We head to the 9th inning. Little Giants leading 8-2.
After the bottom of the 8th inning, Engineers, no runs, no hits, no errors, with 2 runners left on base. Due up for the Little Giants, Logan, Henke, and Nykum. Thank you. Pitching change for Rose-Hulman. Now on the mound, number one, Jackson Summers. The first baseman, number two, Nick Logan.
Another new pitcher into the game for Rose-Hulman, the freshman Jackson Summers from San Juan Capistrano, California. He falls behind 2-0. To the first baseman, Nick Logan. Three balls, no strikes, as that one misses high. That misses inside. It'll be a five-pitch walk. Wabash with another leadoff batter on base. That'll bring up Benjamin Hankey. Hankey squares the bunt. That went in there for strike one. Summers falls behind, two balls, one strike. That one fouled off, two balls, two strikes. The 2-2 pitch from Summers. Fouled out of play. struck him out looking. First out of the inning recorded for Summers. Evan Nykum now with one down and a runner on first base here in the top of the ninth. He's going to pop this one straight up. Summers underneath it, and the pitcher makes the catch out in front of home plate. And there's two down in the inning. That'll bring up the nine-hole hitter, the second baseman, Michael Galanos. Galanos, 1-for-3 on the day, singled and scored back in the seventh inning. Misses, and it's two balls and one strike to the second baseman, Galanos. In there, two balls, two strikes. Summers looking for his second strikeout of the inning. The 2-2. Curveball hit right side, out of the reach of Couillard Rodak, and it'll be a two-out single for Galanos to bring up the top of the order in Reese Bauer. Bauer just 1-for-5 on the day. His one hit a double back in the fifth inning. Looks like we're going to have a pinch runner into the game for the Little Giants. It'll be number 25. That's Bradley Gilliam, the freshman from Greenwood, Indiana, Center Grove High School. That will pinch run for Wabash. Bauer now, two on, two out. Already leading by 6 runs, looking to stretch the lead for the Little Giants. And that one hits the zone. It's 0-1. The 0-2 pitch misses high. It's 1-2. A This one chopped in front of home plate, but it's going to be right off the foot of Bauer. That one hurts. And the Rose-Hulman trainer coming out to check on the center fielder. You hate to see that, especially in this point of the ball game. You just hope he's going to be okay. We'll take a break here in Terre Haute, and we'll be back in a minute for more Rose-Hulman baseball on RHIT.TV. Back to action here at Terre Haute. Reese Bauer stays in the game. The 1-2 pitch is going to be fouled off out of play. It stays 1-2. Throw down to second base. Rasmussen throws out the runner, stealing. Galanos cut down to end the inning. And we head to the bottom of the eighth inning. Wabash leading 8-2. Couple defensive changes for the Little Giants. The left fielder, Camden Scheit, goes to first base. And the new left fielder will be Will Phillips, a junior from Fishers, Indiana. Jackson War, the sophomore from Whitestown and Covenant Christian High School, will be on the mound here in the ninth inning to close it out for Wabash. Busboom pops this one up into shallow right field, and it's going to be caught by the second baseman, Michael Galanos, for the first out of the inning. Connor O'Connell batting now with one out in the ninth. First pitch in there for strike one. He's going to lift this one into left field. Phillips slips, and it's going to be a single for Connor O'Connell. His second base hit of the game, just the fourth hit for Rose-Hulman. The new defensive replacement, Will Phillips, slipped out in left field as he looked to come in on that ball. And it allows O'Connell to reach here with one out in the inning. And that'll bring up Tyler Otresco with one out in the ninth. And he swings first pitch, pops this up into foul ground down the right field line. Shite giving chase, and he's not going to be able to track that down. It'll be a foul ball. Good effort there by Camden Shite at first. And it'll be no balls and one strike. One now to Otresco. War fires. Driven into right field. Camden Early drifting over to his left, and he's going to make the play for the second out of the inning.
Pinch hitting for the Fighting Engineers, number 22, Josh Erpenbeck.
And Josh Erpenbeck now on to pinch hit for the catcher, Mason Rasmussen, with two outs in the ninth. First pitch in there for strike one. That ball misses high. It's 2-1. Foul out of play. Two balls, two strikes now to Erpenbeck as Rose-Hulman down to their final strike here in today's contest. Erpenbeck stays alive, fouls that one straight back. It stays 2-2. Erpenbeck shoots this into shallow center. Bauer on the run, makes the catch, and that'll finish the ball game. Wabash holds on for an 8-2 victory. Rose-Hulman will return to action on Friday night as they travel to Transylvania for a three-game HCAC series. They'll be back here next weekend as they host Bluffton for two games on April 6th at 3 p.m. and 6 p.m. Thank you for watching Rose-Hulman Baseball on RHIT.TV. Have a good night.
Have a good night and try.